In this online class, today we will be discuss about the pivot table. Pivot table in the Excel 2016. Mr. Supreet, have this class? So today start with pivot table. And first discuss the why use the pivot table and what is the reports. First discuss about what are the reports. If you define your reports, then definition is the report is the summary of the data. You can create the any type of the report, any angle of the reports, but main feature is the summary of the sum data. And data is the club of information. So pivot table also use to summarize the data. If pivot table definition is the, we can use the pivot table for analyze the data, summarize the data, and represent of the data, right? So before the applying your pivot table, first understand your data and understand what result will be what. On the screen, we have the one data. We have the one salary data. This is the salary data. In one company, I have the all the employee salary data. And this data have the employee name, employee hiring date, salary, bonus, overtime, departments, which department work, sick days, performance score, city code, and month. Right? And I want to result how many number of employee department every department buys. I want to summary in the number of employees the department buys. Which department has how many employees work? Right, sir? And before the applying your pivot table, think that about two things. First, your heading never be blank because your pivot table considered with the field name. If your field name is a blank, pivot table not created. And second thing, in your data have any blank row, then need to select all data. If you not select the all data, then your pivot table apply only for the sum before the your blank row, because this is the depending on the control A, the control current region that called control A. So if you have the any blank row, completely blank row, then need to select. Not have a blank row, then you can use the pivot table without the selection. Right? Here is the insert pivot table and OK. And then we press the OK, insert the new sheets, and this is the your pivot table windows. Here is the pivot table fields. And I told you pivot table considered with the field name. There is the field name. And there are two area. First filter, column, value, and row. And this field, drag field between this area. And report will be covered. So we have requirement about how many people work in the department. So department wise number of employees summary we have required. So first click on the department and drag the row section. When they drag in the row section, there is the your department will be listed here. Think that in your data have a one department many times repeated, but your pivot sheet one data have a one time. One department have a one time because this is the summary. Right? And second thing, I want to number of employee. So name field, drag the value features. The value features. This is the count, number, sum, every totaling field inside the value section. And this is the your report. But before the sending this report, need to some formatting. First, this is the row level. I want to show here department. You can change any value on your pivot table, but you can't change any figure. The value section have the drag the area field. So your calculated figure, you can't change the calculated figure, but you can change any cell value, just like row section, column section, and heading. We enter the headcount. Okay. And I want to apply the formatting. You have also applied the manual formatting. This is the font alignment and number section. But I want to but if you apply this format, in future your pivot will be increased and decreased, but your format will be not increased, because you have applied the color from the 21 row. But if you refresh your pivot and apply the some data, and maybe your data increased to 25 row. So format will be not applied 25 row.
Hello.
Aate. Sorry, sir. So if you want to apply the format, so you have need to choose the your default pivot format. So click on the pivot table, and on the table pivot table tools, the new tools we showing here, and click on the design, and this is the your design, right? You can choose the any formatting on this area, right, sir? Okay.
Yes, sir.
And I want to report. This is the report department wise, but I want to department and city wise. Both of the legend I want to require. Then you can click on the city code and enter the column here. And your report will be show here department and city wise your headcounts. But remember that. If you any field drag on the column menu bar, need to think that you have in the column have the small legends. If you have more than 500, 300, 400, 1,000, 10,000 legend of the city on the your field, that is the some problem, because this is a very lengthy and complicated rows. Understand, sir? What I'm saying? This is the only for 10 city, right? But maybe you have the 120 cities. There's the horizontally your report will be larger size, and you can't see the one windows, and can't take the printout on the one page. So if you have the large amount of the list in the your column and need to the show your report, that time need to enter the subheading in the row subheading. There is the your reports. Here is the your collapse and expand. You can also collapse the one time cleaver design. This is the collapse, this experiment. And this is the summary of the summary. This is the report, department by report, but I want to city by report in the sales department. Click here and show your city by report. But this type of report you can use, which report, where is the, you're sending the directive with pivot. If you send this report to some people, and if you want to copy and paste another normal data, just like normal data, another sheet, just like normal data, that time have the problem, because in the one column, city and your department will be saved in the column. So if you copy and paste anywhere, so problem to identify which cells have the department and which cells have the city, right? So if you want to copy to another sheets like a normal data, so required increase your column. So required another column. So we have the more options. It's like first key, go to the design menu bar, and we have the show report outline form, tabular form. Select here this type of the options. And second thing, right click on the pivot table and click on the pivot table option and data display. There is the classical table pivot table layout. Click here. Right, sir. And so here, pivot table, the one column have the your department, second column have the your city. But you have the subtotal here. If you want to don't show the subtotal, right click, and here is the subtotal department. Move here. But when the copy and paste the normal data, have a problem key using the filter, and is the main type of the command. This sales with the imperative, just like so here, copy and paste value. Get it? The IT and Pune, but this area will be black. So I want to repeat that, just like that. So in the pivot table, in the design section, have a repeat all item label. Report layout. Repeat all item label. And second thing, if you want to the one separation between the two departments. With the finish your department, we have the you want to the blank row. Select the insert blank row. But you want to the remove the all features, then remove the all blanks, or also do not repeat. And I want to merge your pivot table. This is the merge. I don't want to repeat, but I want to the merge. But you can't merge the directory in the pivot table. If you want to the merge, right click on the pivot table and here is the merge and center with the label, select here and okay. This is the merge and center. It is clear, Mr. Supri?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the data summarization. So next topic will be the sorting, filter, grouping. But I want to please, I give you, send you this file. So please create some summary on this report data. And first, because pivot table is a very important part, so we want to learn this slowly. learn slowly, slowly. Okay, because if you come on with the pivot table, you can create the most report in the office. So I send you this file and please prepare the some reports. Prepare the some reports. And tomorrow discuss the about the sorting, filter, moving, and grouping. Any questions, sir? Okay. Tomorrow, same time?
So, 1 month.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So,